Hi there, this is Teresa. I'm so glad you're joining me today for Teabag Art Tuesday. If you've watched my previous videos and you've returned, yay! I'm really happy that you're here. Your continued support and encouragement means a lot to me. If this is your first time joining us for Teabag Art Tuesday, welcome very much. I hope you will be returning. You can go down below and you can subscribe to my channel and you'll be notified every Tuesday when I do a new drawing. You can give me a thumbs up or you can go ahead and leave me a comment. Any of those things are very good and would be very much appreciated. Let me explain to you a little bit about what I'm doing. Every Tuesday, I am committed to drawing for you on a tea bag. My tea bags are 4.5 by 5.5 inches, and they have been primed with gesso. Today, I did another layer on top of the gesso, and I did an acrylic ground for pastels. This is my first time trying this, so we'll see how it works out. I like to begin each drawing by mapping out the face. And what do I actually mean by that? Is I will draw an oval. That oval is going to represent the size of the face. It's also going to give me the angle of the face that I will be working with. What I do after I have drawn the oval is I put a line right down the center of the oval. This is going to be the approximate location of the eyes. Then as I go down working from the bottom half of that line that I just drew, I'm going to draw another line that is going to be right in the middle of the remaining part of that oval. That line is going to indicate the tip of the nose or underneath the nose. The remaining part of that oval that's left over, I'm going to draw another line right in the middle of that section. And that is going to be indicating where the mouth is going to be. What I do next for my following step, it's never consistent. In this case, I'm going to be adding in some shadows. I'll be using a smaller brush that I am going out of the picture frame and I'm dipping into some pan pastel, and I'm going to be marking the eyes, the nose, and the location of the mouth, as well as defining the shape of the face a little bit more. okay, she's got her lipstick on now. That's a good thing. I'm going to speed up the process, so just back and enjoy her and watch her unfold.